Hi, welcome to Solidedge ST10 video tutorial. I want to do that racing car exercise in Solidedge. Quite similar to the other versions. So, let's have fun with Solidedge. Okay, let's start with a sketch on the front plane. And I need a profile, and that profile could look something like, let's start here, go to the origin and go over there, up, and you could try to snap at least that 90 degree angle here. Okay. Let's give it some dimensions. So this length should be 420, and that's kind of annoying that it doesn't scale it automatically, so I will undo and just do the dimensions like they are at the moment. I need an angle right there. This should be 30 degrees and another one over here. Nope. Which should be 60 degrees. This and of course, yeah, this should be the other way around, like that. Now add a dimension here. This would be, no, that's the wrong one, sorry. It should go from this line to that point, and that would be 775. Then another dimension from that line to this point. This should be 480. Now let's change again. This somehow switched over. Let's see if we can move it up. Not really. So maybe just edit this one to 420 and then draw those two lines here. So this should go, and that length would be 82, and then try to snap. Yes, that length would be 75, maybe. Now let's add this angle right here, which should be 30. And you still have to add, yeah, add 5, and this would be 75. This looks okay. Now I need one more dimension. No. Maybe let's move them a little bit over here so it's better to see. This should adjust automatically, but after all, it's Solidedge. Come on. I just want to move that one a little bit. Okay. I need two circles. So let's draw a circle here and another one over here. Give them dimensions. One would be 640 in diameter, and the other one would be 540 in diameter. Now let's move those circles a little bit. It's really kind of annoying, the whole sketch handling. So this should be somewhere over here. And this point should be on that circle. So go for a coincidence. This point on that arc. And the distance from the circle to that origin point should be 290, like this. Now let's move that circle. It should be somewhere over here, maybe like this. Add dimensions from the circle to that point, and that would be in this direction 255. And another dimension from this one to that point in this direction, and that would be 190. Now I could trim, not yet. I need a line which goes over here and goes down. And now I could trim. This should go away, that should go away, this one, and that side. Now let's add two fillets. One with 70 millimeter radius here, and another one with 100 millimeter radius up there. And I need one dimension from this line to that line, and this should be 30. Now I should have all my dimensions, so I will close that sketch. Finish, cancel this out. I need some planes. Let's see how we can put those planes into our model. I need one which is parallel to that one and should go maybe through this point or through that point. Let's go for this one. Okay, I need another one which is at an angle to this one, perpendicular to that one. Let's see if we can do it like this. But I cannot snap on to, yeah, that's not possible. So I'll do it in a different way. We'll go for a normal to curve one, and the curve should be this one, and I want it to be in that point. So position would be zero. Nice. And the last one would be one which is returned around, revolved around this axis, and should go along that one. Okay, I want to draw some 3D lines, so we'll go for a 3D sketch. And I want to draw lines from this point, snap onto the vertical alignment, and that length would be, I think that's 100. Okay, next one would start here, go straight up, and that length should be 180. Next one would start right here, go straight up, and should be 125, I suppose. And the next one should be over here, and that would be 200. Close that 3D sketch, and now I need some 2D sketches, and let's start with this one. And that radius would be 800, so it's a 1600 arc. diameter. So go for a sketch on this plane right here. And let's rotate it back so I know where to go. I want to go here. I need an arc here. Now I need an arc through 3 points. That would be somewhere over here, yes. Arc by 3 points. And snap, start point, end point, snap. And that radius should be 800. And of course, position it here. Close that sketch. Finish. Next sketch would be on that plane, on this one. I forgot one plane. No, I don't forget. I haven't forgotten one. So, I need another arc. Again, a 3-point arc from this point to that point, and the radius should be 750, and like this. Yep, close this sketch as well. Finish. Next sketch would be on that plane. Let's take a look. Where are we? Okay, like this. Another 3-point arc. Snap this point, that point, and the radius should be 840. Yeah, 840. And close that sketch as well. Finish. Cancel this out. And now I need to make an extrude and then the surface. So let's go for our extrude. I want to extrude this profile in that direction. And this should be, of course, 250. Finish, cancel this out. Okay, so I need a sweep swept. Let's hide that body, go for that swept. And the first step would be to select the path. Let's go for this path. And this should not be a chain, but a single one. Confirm. Then go to next. Go for another single one. That's one single. And that's the other single section. Right click, preview, looks good, finish, cancel this out. In order to split my body, I have to extend that surface because you will see it's a little bit small, so I want to extend that surface just at that edge. And yeah, 100 should do. Or yeah, that's just a little bit too. Let's go for 120 and finish, cancel this out. Now I can split my body. Go to home, go to, where is it? Somewhere here, maybe there. Yeah, there you go, split. I want to split that body with this surface. Confirm, finish, cancel this out. And this should be the active body, yes, so I could hide that body. Now I want to make a sketch on this plane. So for sketch right there, zoom out a little bit and let's draw a sketch. So I want to go for a straight line first, yeah, like this. Don't snap on that edge, like that, and then go for maybe a spline which starts here, goes over there, over here, and then somewhere out of this. And I need a tangency constraint between this line and that spline. This should be for construction only. And this point should be aligned with that point. So go for this alignment, that point with this point right here. Yeah, that's okay. Close that sketch. Finish. Cancel this out. Let's make a surface extrude. There you go, extrude it with that sketch. Confirm. In that direction, maybe, just maybe 250 should do. And in that direction, you could go, yeah, doesn't matter, but you could add just for convenience 10. Confirm, finish, cancel this out. Now I can split my body once more. So go back to home, go to split. I want to split now this body with that surface, and confirm, finish, cancel this out. And which one is which? So hide that one and make this the active body. Now I could mirror that one. So go for mirror, copy part, that body, yes. And the coincident plane would be there. That's the one, that's the front plane. Finish, cancel this out. Nice. Let's hide the sketches and the planes. And add some fillets. Maybe start up there. So go for a round. It would be not a chain, but I want to fillet those two edges with 130. Yeah, it's a little bit too much, so I'll go for 120 in this case. Preview. Finish. Cancel, and that should be, of course, not one. I want 120. More like this, finish. Okay, now let's try. No, I need, of course, that bulge here. I almost forgot this one. So I need to do a sketch on that surface. That's this plane. So go for a sketch on that plane. Yeah, of course. Somehow turns around, so go back. That would be the left view, and I need a line from this point here to that point, and I need an arc, a 3-point arc like this, from this point to that point. and maybe, yeah, 300. Let's go for 300. Okay, close that sketch, finish, and then one on this plane here. Yeah, and again, it's somehow it's on the wrong side, doesn't matter. I go for that bottom view again. I need a line from this point to that point, and then add a 3-point arc, point, point, and the radius might be, yeah, again 300, maybe, just maybe. Close that sketch, and I will need another sketch on that plane. No, that's the front plane, yes. So another sketch on that plane here. Let's take a look. That would be another arc, or I could go for a spline. Let's go for a spline because I need some sort of bulge. So this should be here. I need one point to move over here and then go to the midpoint of that arc here. Okay. And go down a little bit and let's see how big our bulge is. Oh, that's quite big, so let's adjust it a little bit. Maybe like that. Should be not, yeah, that's okay. Close that sketch, finish, cancel this out. Now I could do it with a swept or with a blue surf, but first I might do here a bounded one, so that would be not single but a chain. Like this, confirm, finish, and another chain here, confirm, finish, cancel this out. So let's go for, we have blue surf, why not? Blue surf, and let's say, let's start with that edge here, add another one, add another one, and then go to the next step, and now I need the guide curves, and that would be a single one, yes, this one, and another single one here. Next, finish, cancel this out. Let's hide our body or hide that blue surf which is not stitched. So let's stitch those, this one, that one, and this one. Preview, finish, cancel this out. And now hide that stitched surface, and I could go for bounded, or I could do an offset and make an offset from this face here, and distance should be zero. Finish, cancel this out. Let's hide the body. Let's bring back our stitched surface, maybe hide those sketches, and now I could of course stitch this surface here with that one, and that would bring me a new solid body. Finish. cancel this out. And now I could combine that solid body with that design body by going to home and union this one and that one. Confirm, finish, cancel this out. Yeah, that's okay. And now I could start with my rounds to get the final shape of that seat. Okay, let's start with a round on this edge. And let's go not for a chain. Yeah, but it's only, I could go for an edge and make it, let's say 100. Yeah, looks okay. I could go for more, but let's go for 100. Confirm. Preview. Finish. The other one here. Confirm. Preview. Finish. Then go for this one here. And there I could go no. For a chain maybe, but first I should maybe do this one, so let's cancel this out. Let's see, let's go for a round, go for a chain, that chain, 100 might be, yeah, it's okay. Preview, finish. Then another one up here, maybe not 100 but maybe 50. Preview, finish. Let's go back to this side, and now I want to go around, so I select that one and it should go there, maybe not 50 but let's see, 80. Yeah, looks okay. 80, it's okay. Yes. Preview. Finish. One up here, and there I want to go for edge corner. And this could be maybe 100. Yeah. Preview. Finish. And then this one with 10. Corner, I could go for a chain. Let's cancel this and go for a chain. Go for a chain at 10 millimeters. Select the edge. Yeah. Confirm. Preview. Finish. Now I could go for the shell, in this case it's called thin wall. Thin wall, 30 millimeters, yes, select. That would be offset. Inside, that's okay. So select. Should be the body. Thickness value is 30, yes. And now go for the face. Confirm. Preview, finish, nice. Let's add another round, 10 millimeter, yes, chain, yes, on that chain. Great, it runs all around, nice. Confirm, preview, finish, and same on the inside. Confirm, preview, finish, cancel this out. Yeah, it looks quite nice. Now for the cushions. I should do them at least in one new body. But first I could extract those faces by doing offsets with 0. So go for surfacing. What's that one? Blank surface. That's a flattened surface. Okay, go for offset. And let's start with this one. In that direction. Finish. Then maybe this one. In that direction. Finish. This one. In that direction. It doesn't really matter in which direction you do it. Finish. This one. And that direction. Finish. So that one. And this one. Depending on what kind of fillets you do, you will get different faces, of course. Finish, cancel this out. Now let's hide our design body and maybe put those in different bodies. But first I have to stitch this one with that one. Preview, finish, cancel this out. So let's go for a new body. Go to home, add a body. Name doesn't matter right now. And I want to thicken that one. Not the body, but a single face. Right click in this direction. Yes, 20 millimeters. Yes. Finish. Cancel this out. So that would be a new body, hopefully. Should not be in the same body, but right now it is. That's not really a problem. Maybe I will try to do it with the next one in the correct way, but right now I could already round this, so let's try 40 here. Over there, here, and yes, by accident I clicked the right mouse button. So I want, let's try 50. This one, that one. This one, that one, confirm, preview, finish. Let's try 10 millimeters on that edge. Doesn't go around, so select them. Confirm, preview, finish, cancel this out. Now I want to put this one into a new body. Let's go for add body. Yes. Go for thicken. In this case, not a body, it's a single face. That face. Right click in this direction, maybe 20 millimeters. Finish. Cancel this out. Now it's design body 5. I did it in the correct order. Let's add some rounds. Maybe let's try 50 once more on this edge. No, not this one. That one. And back there. This is already fillet, yeah. So confirm, preview, finish. Let's try 10 millimeters on that edge. Great. Confirm, preview, finish. Cancel this out. Let's add another new body. And go for another thicken. That would be a single face. This face, that should be stitched. I think I did stitch it. Yeah, that would be the stitch. Oh yeah, single. In this case, it's a chain. And I might go for 10 millimeters on this one. Finish, cancel this out. Let's see if we can do rounds here. So go for a round, maybe 30 on this edge, this one, that one, this one. Confirm, preview, finish. And now 5 millimeters on that one. Confirm, preview, finish, cancel this out. Now put those two in new bodies. So go for another add body. Go for another thicken. This surface in that direction, 10 millimeters should do. Finish, cancel this out. Now add another one. Go for another thicken. This one in that direction. Finish, cancel this out. Let's do some rounds. First in this body, make it active, go for a round. Let's see 20, if 20 works, don't know, we will see 20. On this edge, yep. On that edge here, like this, yep. And maybe that one. Confirm, preview, finish, cancel this out, switch to this body, and I went for 20, so go for another round. 20, yes, on this edge, that one, and this one here. Confirm, preview, finish, cancel this out. Yeah, looks okay. So bring back our design body 3, and I've got all the bodies. And now you could, of course, give them different colors. And I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. Of course, you could make a union with all of them. So if you go for a union, so that would be the target, and the other ones should be added. 1, 2 takes a while. 3, 4 and 5. Let's see if it worked. Yes, finish, cancel this out. And now you could, of course, color those faces. Oh, I forgot to make the 10 millimeter fillets here. So undo this one and let's this design body add a 5 millimeter round on this chain. Let's take a look. There it is. And yep, preview finish. Same over here, so make it the active body. Cancel this out. Double click here, round. Select the edges. Confirm, preview, finish. Cancel this out. And now you could make the union. That will be the target, and this will be all the tools. And I still forgot to make that head cushion. Seems I'm a little bit distracted today. Okay, so let's do this one. I could do this in a new body or in the same body. Let's make a new body. But first I need a sketch on this plane here. So go for a sketch here. Zoom out. Go here. And I want to offset or project a curve. I want to project these curves. Therefore I could project the face. So let's make it. Where are we? I want to project. Project is here. Project to sketch. I want to project that single face. Confirm. And then I could make an offset curve of this one. So offset would be, where is the offset? There you go. And it should be a chain, yes. And let's select the chain. Right click and go in that direction, and maybe go for 50, so it's a smaller one. Maybe like this. And this should be, of course, for construction only. But it doesn't really matter. I could do it like this as well. Finish, cancel this out. Now I want to make an extrude, a surface extrude, extruded with that sketch here. Confirm. In that direction, maybe 50, and yeah, it doesn't matter. 10. Doesn't really matter. Confirm. Finish. Cancel this out. And now I could split that face. So go for split, single face, this face with that body. Finish, cancel this out, hide that one. And now I could thicken that single surface here. So I could do it in a new body, add body, yes, go for thicken, not the body, but a single face, and that would be this face, yeah, right click in this direction, maybe 10 or maybe 20, whatever you want, like that, finish, cancel this out, let's add two rounds with maybe 50, on this edge and that edge, or you could go for 60. Preview, finish, cancel this out, and do another round with 10 millimeters on that edge here. Preview, finish, cancel this out. Now I could do finally the union. So go for a union. The target body is this one. And some I already added those, doesn't matter. Now I could add the missing ones, and here, and this one takes a while, confirm, and now I should have only one design body left. Yes, that's the one. Finish, cancel this out. So hope you enjoyed this one, hope you enjoyed my little accidents. If you did, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook fan page. It would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.